Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be going through and solving a problem using the bisection method in Microsoft Excel. So our problem states to find the rightmost root of the following function using the bisection method to an error level of 0.05. Our function here is 4x squared plus 3x minus 3. Just a quick note, if you missed our previous video on the theory behind the bisection method, I will leave a link in the description below for you to check that out first. Just remember that the bisection method is used for finding the roots of a nonlinear equation. So to begin, let's create some headers for our table. So let's assume that A is always going to be our lower boundary input value, and B is going to be our higher boundary input value. C is going to be our midpoint value, which will be found based off our A and B values. F of A, F of B, and F of C will be found using the function's output, which we are solving for. Next, we need a column that determines which of these two outputs, f of a times f of c and f of b times f of c, gives a negative value, and this will tell us which direction we need to move in, whether it is left or right. Then lastly, we just need to calculate the error at any given iteration, which is simply our higher boundary b minus our lower boundary a. Now, for the first iteration, we need to assign a and b values based on what we found in our positive or negative product test that we performed in the previous iteration. To accomplish this, we are going to use a simple if statement. So, to do so, we type equals, if, and then a logical statement. So that means something that will be either true or false. So, we select the value given by f of a times f of c and test if it is less than 0. If true, that means our root is to the left of our midpoint, and A will remain unchanged, whereas B will take on the midpoint value. If false, then the root is to the right of the midpoint, and A will take on the midpoint C value. We repeat the same formula for our higher root boundary, B. Now, we are free to bring down all of the other rows. Every time we create a new row like this, we are basically iterating another step, much like we did in the previous video, except this method is much faster. As you can see, after 5 iterations, our error term is lower than our acceptable value, which means that we are done. We could also visually depict our function and boundaries in the following way. Create small steps in the x direction, let's say 0.01, and we will go from our initial boundaries of 0 to 1. Then, beside this, we can apply these inputs to our function, and we get the outputs. Next, we can graph the function and visually see that we do indeed have a root between these two points, 0 and 1. Next, let's create two points in space to visualize our lower root boundary at iteration 5. So, using the same x-axis and some arbitrary higher and lower y values, we can achieve this vertical line. And we just repeat this for our higher root boundaries at 0.59375. And there you go. We just have completed a problem using the bisection method in Microsoft Excel. One additional thing that you can do, and is really cool, is to add a validation that we have a root within two boundaries. So, to accomplish this, let's create an if-or statement, which states that if f of a times f of c, or f of b times f of c, and just note the syntax here, is less than 0, we can print true. There is at least one root present. And if it is false, we print that. The only times this could give you trouble is if you have more than one root present within your boundaries, and you can ensure that you don't simply by graphing the function like we did here. So, just as a final note here, you can really use this Excel sheet you just created to solve for any function you want to solve using the bisection method. All you need to do is adjust the formula here for f of a, and copy and paste that into f of b, f of c, and f of x for iteration 0 and 1 here. Copy and pasting works here in this formula as our input term is always just to the left of the function we're solving for, which is the output for the given input. Then, lastly, you just adjust your boundaries a and b to contain a single root within them. This may take some adjusting, but can easily be done through plotting the function like we did on the right here. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we find the roots of a function through the bisection method in Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.